Data references are used to associate various items to attributes in your AF hierarchy. In the case of PiePoint data references, we have the option to add value retrieval methods. Value retrieval methods change the type of requests for data made to the PyData archive, based on the time context of the client. Before hopping onto PySystem Explorer to configure a PyPoint data reference with a value retrieval method, let's explore what's meant by the client time context. The most simple time context is the current time, often denoted by star in PyTime. PySystem Explorer as a client is set to have a time context of now by default. But a single timestamp can also be some specific time in the past or future, including T, Y, or even a specific time. Time context can also refer to a time range with both a start and end time, in this case from now to 24 hours ago. We may want to request summary data over that time range, such as a time-weighted average, event-weighted average, maximum, minimum, or others. Let's start by looking at a simple value retrieval method configuration designed to take the average over a time period and see how its settings interact with the start or end time passed by different clients. Three of the by time configurations are used for summary calls or calls that require a time range. Those three are time range override, and not supported. Let's start with time range and request a time weighted average. One additional important piece of information is relative time. Here we've chosen a relative time of 24 hours. But what exactly does this mean? Since PSE by default has an end time context of star, but no start time context, the time range to be used when calculating the average will assume to go back 24 hours into the past from the end time context of star passed by PSE. However, some clients like PyVision and PyProcessBook will pass both a start and end time, so the value of 24 hours as the relative time is not actually used by that client. These clients will use the start and end times of the display. So when using time range, the relative start time is used if the client doesn't have its own start time context. So what do you do if you want PyVision and PyProcessBook to also use 24 hours for the average, even if the display time range isn't 24 hours? This is why you use time range override. In this case, the end time of the summary call refers to the end time of the display. But the summary call is forced to be the end time minus 24 hours, since we're using time range override. The third summary call is not supported. Not supported requires that both the start and end time are provided by the client. For PyVision and PyProcessBook, these will be the start and end times of the display. However, since PySystem Explorer by default has only an end time context of now, and by default no start time context, not supported will show an error in PSE. There are a large number of time range options that can be selected when using time range: time range override, and not supported. We used average, and the others are mostly self-explanatory, but details are provided in the documentation linked below. Also, if you wish to use a calculation basis other than time-weighted, please see the documentation. So what about the other by-time options? The other options don't refer to summary calculations over a time range, instead are used with a single time context. In PSE, again, this is by default now, but for PyVision and PyProcessBook, we've selected the by time range to be the end time of the display. Now that we have a different time context depending on what client we're using, we need to determine how to find a value at this time, and seven options are available. After refers to the first value after the timestamp, while at or after is the first recorded value at or after the timestamp, as expected. However, note that in both PSE and PyVision, this is also interpreted as the snapshot. So even if the value is before the client end time, it still will return that snapshot. Similar definitions exist for before and at or before. Note that automatic and interpolation are very similar, but there is a slight difference in the timestamp returned when the tag is set to step. And one final note on using a single time context. Relative time is a time delay from the time context in this basis. Let's go ahead and set up a simple example. We have an attribute being the pump flow rate in gallons per minute. We would like three more attributes that show the total flow so far today, this month, and this year. In each case, the relative time is set to determine the time range over which we would like to take this total. Just a couple more notes before we hop onto PiSystem Explorer. The calculation is resolved locally by the client and is not saved in a Pi tag. Since it is resolved locally, this also means that Pi time, like T, or the midnight associated with today, is the local time of your client. So different people on different machines in different time zones will have different midnights resolving for this calculation. With that said, let's hop onto PSE to set this up. Here in PSE, we have our inlet pump with our attribute pump flow rate. And if we go ahead and trend the data, we can see that we tend to have about 1.1 gallons per minute. Let's go ahead and create the value retrieval method attributes that we discussed. Let's create them as new child attributes because it'll help us keep them organized. The first one will be total flow so far today. And let me go ahead and click on settings to assign it as a PiPoint data reference. Instead of selecting the tag name directly, let's just reference the attribute above. It'll automatically fill in the units of measure. And for value retrieval method, I'm going to use time range override and use a relative time of T for today at midnight. For by time range, I want the total flow over that time. So I'm going to go with total. We do need to make a correction for units of measure to explicitly tell it that we have our inlet in gallons per minute. And let me go ahead and click OK. And does this value make sense? It's about 16 hours into the day since it's 4 p.m. and we have a flow rate of about a little over one gallon per minute. So a total flow today of about 1100 does make sense here. Now, just as a reminder, this is the total flow from T at midnight today on this client machine to star, since PSE is passing in a end time context of now. But this could look slightly different if you're on a different machine, since T could resolve to a slightly different time because it'll be midnight local to that time zone. And also the end time context may be slightly different if, for instance, your PiVision display doesn't have an end time of now. Let's make another child attribute for the total flow so far this month. Let me click settings and I'll again assign it to the attribute. Value retrieval method by time is time range override. And by time range, again, will be total. And I'll make sure to correctly set the units of measure. Relative time in this case is going to be a value of 1. Since in Pi time, 1 refers to the day of the month, and then it automatically defaults to the current month, the current year, at midnight, which would be midnight on the first of the month. And again, this value looks reasonable. Let's go ahead and right-click and create another one's total so far this year. Click on the attribute, pump flow rate, time range override, total. And a relative time this time is going to be January 1st. Then it'll assume the current year and midnight on that day. And each time I hit refresh, it's actually going to re-query the PiData archive for the data over this time range, and the client is then going to update. Now, just to be consistent, let's make sure that we set our units of measure explicitly on what we would like to output. And these will not be saved to Pi tags. So here we have the total so far today, this month, and this year, PiPoint data references as value retrieval methods. Now that you understand how the time context of the client interacts with value retrieval methods of PiPoint data references, you can set up summary or single value calculations and understand how different clients interact with these settings.